Have you ever wanted to trim the beginning, middle, or end of a video on YouTube after you've uploaded it and not lose the comments, views, and rankings? Now you can with the new YouTube video editor, and I'm going to show you how to do it in this video. My name is Herman Drost from drostdesigns.com. If you want to grow your audience on YouTube and generate traffic, leads, and sales on autopilot, hit the subscribe button and click the bell notification icon so you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. Here are the main benefits of using the new YouTube video editor. Number one, ability to trim an existing video on YouTube. You no longer have to delete the video or download the video to cut out the unwanted section in your video editing software. Number two, views, comments, and rankings remain unchanged. After you've edited your existing video on YouTube, the views, comments, and rankings remain the same. Number three, increase watch time. Your viewers will be more inclined to watch a long video if you've trimmed out the parts where you were rambling. This comes in really handy for live streams. Here are the steps to trim an existing video on YouTube using the new YouTube video editor. You need to use the YouTube Studio Beta, so go to your video manager, click on YouTube Studio Beta, select the video that you wish to trim, so I'm going to select this one, and you'll notice the editor is in the left-hand column. Click editor. I haven't used this, so it says editing just got easier. Our new editor makes it faster than ever to adjust and enhance your videos all within a single consolidated timeline. We're still adding features so you can expect to see more appearing in the coming months. Make sure to check back regularly. Get started. Here's my video clip. At the top here, you've got undo changes, redo the changes. On the right, you got discard changes and save the changes. You'll be saving the changes to the existing video. Over here, you click on the three buttons. You got keyboard shortcuts, so I can zoom in, zoom out. I can fast forward 10 seconds. And when focused on the time code, you can increase the value, decrease the value. This comes in handy when focused on the player. Seek backwards by 5 seconds, so use the arrow keys. Seek forwards by 5 seconds. And you can increase the volume by 5%, decrease the volume by 5%. And on the video itself, you've got the play button. Skip back to 10 seconds. Skip forward to 10 seconds. Adjust the audio. And over here, you got the speed settings. So you can do a slower speed or faster speed. Then you can also do the full screen. Underneath the video, you've got the time, like seconds and frames. You got trim, a blue outline goes around the timeline. And you got the video at the top of the timeline, then the audio under that, and then the end screen. It says end screens can only be added to videos that are at least 25 seconds long. You can also extend the timeline if you move the slider so you can see more details. Now we're going to trim a part of the video. Slide the playhead to where I want to trim the video. So let's trim it at 5 second mark, click split. Then I just move the playhead down to like maybe 10 seconds. So it's going to cut out that middle section. If I hover over the X, it says undo split if I want to undo it. If I want to remove another section, just move the playhead to where I want to split it. Click split. Don't grab the top of it because that doesn't do anything. You have to grab the middle of it, somewhere on the timeline itself. Find out where, how far you want to go to remove that section. Now I've got 2 sections that I want to remove, but I can remove even more sections if you want. And then after you've done that, you can just save the changes. So if I exit, I can undo the split. I can go up to the top and click undo and it'll split again. After you're satisfied with all your changes, click preview. Then you just play it, see if everything works out. Yep. It works. Click save to save the changes. And it says save changes to existing video. Saving these changes will cause your existing video to be updated. This action is irreversible and it may take up to a few hours to process these changes. During that time, viewers will see the current version of the video and you will be unable to make additional changes. While the video is being processed, you are free to leave this feature and edit your other videos. Down the bottom here, it says video is being processed. Please check back later. Now, if I go over to Creator Studio Classic, I get a banner across my video that says edit in progress. Now I have to wait a few hours for the video to finish processing.
So how can you use the new YouTube video editor? Number one, trim the end of an old video, then add an end screen. Number two, trim out the ums and ahs you missed during the video editing process. Number three, cut out any unwanted sections of your live stream. Number four, use it anywhere you have an internet connection and a computer. Let me ask you an important question. What features would you like to see added to the YouTube video editor? Post your answer in the comments below. I'd love to read them and I'm sure others would too. If you need help growing a YouTube channel, click the subscribe button below
and check out the related videos over here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.